there's so much to see and do. First, we visited a butterfly sanctuary where there was a variety of butterflies of different colors and sizes. We were met by a guide who led us through the various phases of metamorphosis. As we entered the butterfly sanctuary, the guide gave us the idea to use the dishes of banana to attract the butterflies. After spending a few hours photographing and studying the butterflies, we went across the street where the trucks were waiting with the rafts for us to go tubing. We split up into three groups of seven and floated down the river with a guide to help us in case we got stuck, which happened a lot. After we got back from tubing, we split into our OA groups. The photo kids were given an assignment to shoot candids of the locals in town. It was really interesting to have the opportunity to meet the locals one-on-one. Tomorrow we plan on having an early start and look forward to another day in Mindo. Hasta mañana!
Our second day in Mindo was as exciting as the first. In the morning, we drove up to the cable cars, which brought us to the beginning of our hike. Nikki, our Mindo guide, led us to the waterfall. Along the way, Nikki worked with the wilderness and conservation students pointing out various flora and fauna, while the photography students focused on their OA projects. Once we arrived at the waterfall, we slowly made our way into the frigid waters. We took some time to get acclimated to the temperature, but once we had a great time around the waterfall. After the waterfall, we played soccer with the local children at our hacienda. It was boys versus girls, and the boys barely beat the girls 3-2. In the early evening, we walked into town to photograph the locals and get to know them better. We had an early dinner because we have a busy morning planned tomorrow.